الحمد الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبنا وشفيئنا وقدوتنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن المتقين في جنات وعيون آخذين ما آتاهم ربهم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك محسنين كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون وفي أموالهم حق للسائل والمحروم وفي الأرض آيات للموقنين وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him. We ask forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils of our own souls and from our wicked deeds. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy beside Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is His servant and His last messengers. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, every one of us and every human being, they're looking for something in Arabic called al-khair, good. Everybody want to have good, right? Good in your life, good in your health, in your income, everything. And very interesting, there is a dua Rasulullah used to recite. He said every after salat, the following dua. And he said, Allahumma aslih li fi dini alladhi huwa ismatu amri wa aslih li fi dunyaya allati fiha ma'ashi wa aslih li fi akhirati allati ilayha ma'adi waj'al hayata ziyadatan li fi kulli khair وَجَعِلْ مَوْتَ رَحَةً لِي مِنْ كُلِّ شَرٍ So if you don't memorize, so you have to memorize. Rasulullah said, he always يَقْرَى دُبُرَ كُلِّ صَلَةٍ After salat, he read this. And what's the meaning of this? So the first said, اللهم أصلح لي. Oh Allah, set right for me. Right? My religion, which is the safeguard of my affairs. The word islah in Arabic, opposite a word fasad. Fasad means corruption. So therefore when somebody fight, they said, can you do islah? To make them have good relation again. Suluh. Suluh also means peace. Peace treaty. So when he said aslih can be, oh Allah, set right, or make it good, or improve in my religion. Because religion is isma. Isma means the protection. If my religion good, I'll be protected in this life and next life. So the first thing Rasulullah mentioned is five requests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is about deen. This hadith also want to advise us, you have to be concerned about this deen. And it's all the Prophet. Ibrahim alayhi salam and Yaqub, Allah recorded in the Quran. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِي وَيَعْقُوبُ Remember when Ibrahim and Yaqub gave advice to their children. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ Allah did choose for you the religion of Islam. فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Die not except you be a Muslim. Submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next ayah, Am kuntum shuhada. You know, are you witness when Yaqub said to his son, It's the same, right? So as a Muslim, when you're going to do anything, your barometer, your basis has to be deen. You want to start business, look at the deen. It's halal or haram. Even when you're going to get married, right? What the Prophet said? Tunkahul mara'atu li arba. Marry woman because of four things. Li jamaliha, wa li hasabiha, wa li maliha, wa li diniha. Because of her beauty, her wealth, her family, and her religion. If you have four all this, you are lucky. If not, you have one of them, but there is religion in it, deen, fadfar bidati deen. Marry that girl. That Rasulullah said, dofi, that means you'll be lucky. You'll be the winner. Because when you have a woman and she has religion and you have some problem, you bring to the imam, and imam give hadith, the Quran, she will listen. But no deen, bye-bye. The same with the sister, if you want to get married, the same, the basic word deen. إِذَا أَتَيْتُمْ مَنْ تَرْضَنَهُ دِينَهُ وَخُلُقَهُ فَزَوِّجُهُ. If somebody come to you, would like to engage with your daughter, so for woman, Allah address the parent. And you please with his deen and akhlaq, fazawiju. You know, let her marry with that man. Right? So therefore, long time ago, when somebody want to engage with his daughter, you know, the father invite that person on the Maghrib time. Maghrib time, not Dhuhr time. Why Maghrib time? So at time for pray, you know, his future father-in-law want to test him. He said, I have coffee, can you lead the salat? So they come to check. Shh. Sister, you cannot talk when you have khutbah. So when the father, he know, mashallah, have you. It's guaranteed. No invite, no people invited in the whole time. Right? And they're testing what? They give the key, you know how to drive or not. Right? Before, even some of them, the mahar is Surah Yasin. People screaming, no, the dowry is Surah Yasin, yaki. Right? There, so the deen is very important. Right? In the West, deen is dead. Deen is not number one. Deen is your private life. Don't talk about deen. Right? And they try to bring people to deen. You know, Sheikh Zaid Shakir said the reason they bring the piano and music and dancing in the church to attract people to come to the deen. But it's not work also. Right? So, but the Prophet said aslih, that means improve. But if you every day said, Allahumma aslih li fi dini, and you not make effort, dua will not work. So question to all of us, how many hours you spend every day or every week to learn about deen? Some might be zero, subhanAllah. In 1 week, you never improve your deen. Even on Friday, there should be opportunity, come late. And some of them, they saw in the khutbah, inna alhamdulillah, sleep. And some people make the best sleep in the khutbah time. So you have to make effort. In our masjid, alhamdulillah, we have halaqah on Friday. We have halaqah on Sunday. Come, even you know already, make effort, bring your family. That's how to increase the deen. If you're not the effort, and very interesting, I'm sorry if I've criticized you. You can have time for what? Aqiqah, wedding, everybody was ready an hour before. But when it comes to ta'lim, subhanAllah, no time. Have many things, right? So asli, we have to improve, right? Improve in our ibadah. How many of us we improve our ibadah? SubhanAllah, in 30 years I pray, I cannot communicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I have to understand this book. You know, when you understand just Fatiha, you will enjoy salat. Look at when you Fatiha, the first you praising Allah. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin. Alhamdulillah, you, Ar-Rahman is you, Maliki Yawmiddin. And then he said, Iyyaka Na'budu, you Allah. You are talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, wa iyyaka, Iyyaka Na'budu, you know, we worship you. And then I cannot really able to worship as perfect. Wa iyyaka kana sayyin, please help me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ihdinas siratul mustaqim, please keep me on this guidance. Don't make me among the maghdub or dhalim. If you feel that you are talking, your salat is enjoy. You can enjoy your salat. How much knowledge you have about Quran, you have it Quran, but you cannot have that kind of feeling when you talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, useless. And you cannot do that unless you improve your knowledge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right. And also, when he said deen, religion, some Muslim religion means ceremonial thing. And they only run religion when they are born. They call adhan. That's deen. Then aqiqah. And the next time is when they have a wedding. Call the imam. That's only religion. And the last one, what? Janazah. That's religion only. And even in nikah, they call the imam. I was invited one day. They call the imam, and he said, I marry you based on the Quran and Sunnah. Ala kitabillah sunnat rasulihi. After the marriage often, husband, this new husband wife was dancing in the front of the public. You said, I marry you based on Quran and Sunnah. That's only that moment. And then after that, khalas, Quran, Sunnah, bye-bye. That's because we don't improve our understanding of religion. How Allah SWT going to make islah? Aslihi. Right? So the hadith said, ismatun fi amrina. Make religion become isma because of protection, preservation in our affairs. That's the first dua Rasulullah SAW, to have islah in our deen. The second dua, he said, wa aslih li dunyaya allati fiha ma'ashi. And also set right for me in my world wherein is my living. Subhanallah. How beautiful the religion. Always Islam in balance. Deen and dunya. Never contradict. Muslim didn't want, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't want us to be like angels, just flying in the sky. Right? Rasulullah immediately, after asked Allah to have good in religion, the next one was good in this life, in dunya. Right? So therefore why Islam is religion concerned about the environment. Al-ihtimam bil-bi'ah. If you read the fiqh book, I said, Babul Bi'ah, a special chapter about how to take care of the environment. So as a Muslim, as a Khalifa in this world, it is our duty to take care of the environment, to take care of the trees, the animals. Umar used to punish somebody if they are give too much job to the animal and they feed it little, right? It is our duty to protect the water from pollution. It is wajib because, you know, we have to make wudu, we have to drink, we have to take shower. If the water is pollution, we cannot use it. And the hadith said in the usul fiqh, ma la yatimu al-wajib illa bi fa wajib. If that wajib cannot fulfill at least by death, that become wajib. Like for example, we're living here, and the masjid is have to pass the river. So building the bridge is wajib. So to have a tailor is wajib. So preserving the environment to have good health is also part of religion and also part of the ibadah. Right? Even in the hadith said, if you know that tomorrow is day of judgment, or if you know you're going to die, and you have seed in your hand, he said, plant it. If you're going to die tomorrow, you plant it. The Prophet said, Because Muslim not live for himself. Muslim always concerned about the others. Even nobody eat it, he said, if the bird eat that, you will get reward. It becomes sadaqah jariyah. It's the running charity. So, deen, dunya, and then Rasulullah again, he said, wa aslih li akhirati allati fiha ma'adi. He said, set right for me my akhirah, my next life. Yeah, to wit is my return. Subhanallah. Rasulullah used the word ma'adi from ada, return. What it mean? You know, if you are traveling, right? And then what? You return where? Home. So this word is not our home. That's the reason Allah SWT did put Adam in Jannah in the beginning. Because Allah SWT want to tell us, hey, Jannah is your home. You have to go back to your home. This word is not your home. You know, if you're going from here to California, and then you stop in that rest area, that rest area where we live now. How long we live in this rest area? Just for a moment. The Prophet said, "Kun ka'abiri sabil," be like people who are traveling to the akhirah, right? This word, like the Prophet said, "Mazra'ah," like a farm. Whatever seed you plant, you will see the harvest. Yes, Allah SWT wanted to be rich. Rasulullah SAW used to make dua, Allahumma inni a'udhibika minal faqr. Wallah, I seek refuge from poverty. Because when you're rich, you can do a lot of things. But don't make that wealth become your goal, become your purpose. You know, because a Muslim, whatever Allah, when Allah give anything to them, the other get benefit. When Allah give a Muslim a knowledge, the other get benefit because they always like to share the knowledge. When Allah give them a position, they really put this position to serve the people. The way are the same. When he die or she die, everybody was crying, oh man, I miss him, I miss her. Because they always they give benefit to the others, right? And some people, sometimes, they're only concerned about the future in this life. Oh man, I want to save for this life. So inshallah, when I have retirement, I'm going to enjoy my life. But what's guarantee? Because the angel of death will come to us, we not ask question, are you ready? Right? Then check your health, or your status, a green card, or citizen, then test nothing. Right? Like a fiction story, an angel of death come to a young man, and young man said, I'm not ready. The angel said, I'm sorry, I do my job according to my list, you are next. Oh please, I'm not ready. And then the angel insists, the young man said, oh, can you tell me how much time I have? He said, less than 1 hour. Okay, can I give you something, I cook for you. So the young man cooked biryani and feed the angel. And they drink tea and then he slept. While they were sleeping, the young man, he took the list. So he's looking for his name, the last first one put in the end. I said, good. So the angel woke up, Allah Zakallah khair, the biryani was good. Because you are a good man, I will not start from the top, from the bottom. Of course, not true story, because angel didn't eat. But what does it mean? Iza ja'a ajalhum, when the ajal came, you chain whatever name, you burn the next. So we have to be prepared for that, right? Number four, Rasulullah said, وَجْعَلْ حَيَاتَ زِيَادَةً لِي فِي كُلِّ خَيْرٍ. He said, make the life a source of abundance for every good for me. How many of you have a friend or relative that passed away already? They're younger than you. Many, right? So Allah give you bonus. Ziyadah, Allah give you bonus. So you have to take opportunity of this bonus. Right? That means Allah SWT still love you. Give you more time. If you are 50, no. Why Allah give you more time for you?
الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ
liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsanu amala. Who created death and life in order what? To test you, who among you the best in good deed. He said, khairukum man tala umruhu wa hasuna amala. The best among you, you have long life. So the word khair, that means when Allah give you more life, Allah extend you, make it every breath, every of your action is become khair. Khair for you, khair for others. Your tongue become khair, become good. When the Prophet asked was question, he said, who is Muslim? Qala man salima muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi. The Muslim, when the other Muslim, save from his tongue and his hand. That's the real Muslim. And how to use this time? I just want to give some suggestion, inshallah. Maybe it's good for me, even for you. What is the problem with us? We didn't have really good connection with the Quran. And we have to improve that in order to change our life better. The first, try to sleep early and wake up early. Try to pray Fajr on time every day and read Quran. Because Allah mentioned special, Inna Quran al-Fajri kana mashhuda. Quran, you read in Fajr, become witness in the judgment. You see the light. If you cannot come every day to the masjid for Fajr, just once a week, try it. You don't know the happiness when you come to Fajr for the masjid, even once. You can ask people who are come every day. And some of them have to, I know, so have to drive 20 minutes and still come. And you can see in the face. But you only can on Ramadan, this is, you don't have any concern about the bonus Allah gives to you. When I come to Indonesia, I saw a friend. He was have paralyzed. You know, in Indonesia you can hear Adhan everywhere. When the Adhan was calling, he cried. I said, why are you crying? I was very strong. I was drive everywhere. But I never, when Adhan was calling, I went in the masjid. No, I feel guilty. Inshallah, Allah give you good health. What could happen to anybody? One day said, I wish I can come for Fajr. I can come for Isha. And the time is past. And then try, at least, all of us, I think, memorize Juz Amma. Many of us that you read every day. Try to understand. Spend time. There's many YouTube to understand. Okay, I always read Inna Atainaka Wahad. Try to study deeply. So when you said Inna Atainaka, you will be different. But you never studied the book of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. And even you read Quran, you don't understand. They will affect you. Even just one page every day. Like this, a boy said, Daddy, I don't understand nothing of Quran. Just read it, man, will benefit you. Daddy, what's the point? So they was on the beach, and he asked him to bring the bucket and bring the water. But there's a hole on the bucket. So the man went to the beach and took the water and ran, it's gone. So do it again, do it again. After 15 times, Daddy, what's the point? Can you see the bucket? He said, yes, what? It's clean. That's the bucket. When you read Quran, you just repeat Allah's word. If you understand, it will clean you. If not clean us, there's something wrong. Am ala qulubin akfaliha. Aqulu qawli hadha wa atlu li wa lakum. Udu umma wa antum. Alhamdulillah ya fi ni'amika fi mazidah. Ya Rabbana lakal hamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa 'azimi sultanik. Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alaihi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik 'alaih. So Allah give us bonus, still alive, alhamdulillah. You know, try to make your connection to Quran strong. So read it, understand it, and memorize it. Can you imagine you are for 5 years, you read the same surah, you know, every month, try to have fun. You don't say, oh, I'm too old. I have a story. There's a Hafid was in the masjid, was reading Quran, and the old man come closer and closer to him. And after finish, can you teach me a Quran? I want to memorize Quran. But I couldn't read and write. I said, he was 8 years old. I said, okay. So every day he recites 5 ayah and memorize it. So the man come every day, teach him. In 4 years, he memorized, alhamdulillah, half of the Quran. When he returned on Asar and looking for the man, he said he passed away. And he was passed away whilst reading Quran. He loved Quran. It's nothing too late. Right? And the last one, the Prophet said, وَجْعَلْ مَوْتَ رَوْحَةً لِي مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مِنْ كُلِّ شَرٍ. He said, make my death sources of comfort for me, protecting me against every evil. So that means, Ya Allah, if you take my soul, let take my soul and I am in peace with you. Like Bilal, when Bilal in Sakaratul Maut, his family was crying. He said, don't cry. غَدًا أَلْقَى الْأَحِبَّةِ مُحَمَّدًا وَصَحْبَةِ. This is the time of happiness, he said. Because tomorrow, I'm going to meet my beloved Muhammad and his companion. Subhanallah. Sa'id al-Musayyib, one of the greatest scholars in Syria, when he's going to die, his family also crying. They said, don't cry. Why, daddy, you? Because alhamdulillah, the adhan never called in the masjid unless I was in the masjid for 40 years. So somebody always come to the masjid early, and somebody said, why you always come before adhan? He said, al-adhan lil-ghafilin. Adhan is to remind people who are headless. I am, alhamdulillah, not among the headless. And the last one, there is a girl, very young girl. When the ice cream passed by her house, she makes sujood. And she was so happy. And the guest was came and said, why you make sujood? Because I saw my mother, when she's happy, she gets something, she makes sujood. Allah. So when people see you as parent do that, the kid will follow you, inshallah. Allahumma ja'alna minal ladhina yastamuna qala fa yattabiuna ahsana. Allahumma hina ala al-islam wa sunnah wa tawaffana ala al-imani wa tawbah. اللهم اجعل خير عمرنا آخره وخير عملنا خواتمه وخير أيامنا يوم نلقاك في إنك على كل شيء قدير. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا ربكم وأقيموا الصلاة.
Allahu Akbar.